anti-black men, but find their love and romance in the arms of either a white man or another woman. And once we see it a couple of times on TV, we become desensitized to it, and all of a sudden, the sin is if we judge folk who disagree with the lifestyle. Media shapes our images. And that's why we have to be woke. So that we don't deny fundamental truth to embrace some alleged truth that the media wants to sell us on. Effective Christianity is more than a thermometer. Effective Christianity is also a thermostat. See, a thermometer can reveal the temperature. A thermostat will regulate the temperature. Much of our modern-day Christianity is just thermometer Christianity. Whatever the temperature is out there, we bring it here. If it's 80 degrees outside, we're supposed to have an 80-degree church. If it's 30 degrees outside, we're supposed to have a 30-degree church. And we do nothing to affect change in society. We only try to mirror what we see on the outside. Charlottesville, Virginia, protests occurred primarily from two groups. Many of you will be shocked to hear this. Came from two groups. You'll know it's true, but you won't know the meaning of the truth. There was the alt-right, short for alternative right, and Antifa, short for anti-fascist. Alt-right accused Antifa of being communist, and Antifa opposes fascism, which is a form of radical nationalism, which is what alt-right was. So you've got these two groups. And if you look at both of these groups, they are both known to bring violence with their protests. This was really not about us. This was not about the rights and privileges of African American people. That's why there were so few of us in the crowd. All of this started because alt-right got a permit to protest the removal of a Confederate statue, and Antifa came to protest their protest. Both groups are known to not like each other and to demonstrate their disapproval of each other through violence. And so while race is a factor, it was really not the motivation of the protest. Race is certainly a factor of the alt-right's views and their hate doctrines, but it was not just for them race. There's a whole list of dumb stuff they believe. And so you generally got two white mobs angrily clashing against each other. And the media has made us think it's a race issue. If you want to know what the race issue is, I'll tell you what the race issue is. The race issue is that there was a level of police tolerance that we would not see if it had been us. All right, was pushing police back. You try. And see, can you come back here and tell us about it? Racism is not about ignorant people being prejudiced. Racism is about positioned people establishing discriminatory public policy. All right. All right. Somebody doesn't like me because of my skin color, that's their ignorance. Yeah. Long as you can't stop nothing. Amen. Come on, help me somebody. Amen. And if we get into this rage of hating everybody who looks different than us because we're in this race war. Y'all, the reality is most of the folk who have these racist views aren't even respected by the ones who taught them to hate. White hate should not be our fear. 93% of homicides in the black community are black on black crime. And that doesn't make us any different. 84% of homicides in the white community is white on white. Racism, ISIS, and fascists are not our biggest physical threat. What we are concerned about is that when we kill each other, then often there's not enough policing to care. Right. And then when they kill us, there's enough policing to protect them. Yeah. You go out in the woods and kill a deer out of season. You're in trouble. Late Vernon Johns preached the sermon, "It's Safe to Murder Negro." Because he says that if you're white and you murder a Negro in the South, that if there are no consequences, but if you shoot an animal out of season, then you'll at least get a fine, if not in prison. That's what we're concerned about, is that there are public policies that protect people who have prejudice feelings. Yeah. There are some who hate you and me for no clear reason. They don't even know why they hate you. Yeah. And some people who hate to see you coming because the color shoes you got on. They think they look good. They ain't all. Murmur when you come up, "Good to see you." But we ought not stress ourselves and miss, lose sleep, worrying about folk who don't like us, who can't hurt us. If the Klan was marching down the street, y'all know we ain't going down there to protest. We ain't carrying ourselves down there. If they don't mess with us, we ain't gonna mess with them. This protest was not about race. And so if the media is creating this whole race issue, we have to be wise enough to realize that if it's creating a racial tension, because the KKK never died. Just because the media weren't talking about it doesn't mean they weren't protesting. It doesn't mean that they weren't policing. It doesn't mean that they weren't doing their dirt. They've always been alive, but suddenly we're getting more exposure to it because something is going on that somebody behind the scenes that's controlling media can profit from racial tension. So we've got to stay alert, woke, conscious, wise. For as in this text, God has something to say. In this text, Joel prophesies to the southern kingdom of Judah. Assyria has been used of God to pour out God's wrath upon Judah. And the bright joy of being God's people has been blighted by the ravages of war because they've been disobedient. God says, "Wake up, you drunkards." Now, what is he referring to? He's talking to these people who will drink themselves into a stupor so they can pretend they don't see what he is. Now, I want to tell you, there's some drunk Christians. Some will get drunk not off of the wine of the world. Some will get drunk off of a mystical imagination. Yeah. that we don't have to do nothing but just believe. And so if we praise our way through it, everything's going to work out okay. No, God says, wake up and look at reality as it is. Stop pretending like you don't see what you see. Stop acting like what is not. Wake up. And if the church is asleep, if the church is drunk, if the church ignores reality, we can't speak to folk who got to live reality. Amen. The fact of the matter is, the black church is in trouble. Amen. Because we've become so carnal. Yes. Come on, help me, somebody. Yes. You hear more messages about individual prosperity than you do about purpose and following Christ. You hear more about what God is going to do for us than what we are supposed to do for God. We hear more messages that tickles our fancy than those that have to do with truth and faith. And if we don't wake up, we will forever be talking about some superficial pie in the sky without dealing with the reality that people are living in. And people are leaving churches because we aren't addressing things from a truthful standpoint. We're telling them that Santa Claus, we call Jesus, is going to fix everything while we praise him until he does. And the Bible is consistently telling us what he's saying to us in this text. Wake yourself up. We won't mobilize as churches to build communities. We'd rather compete against each other as churches to try to prove to the other church we more blessed than they are. Have you ever heard of somebody say that their church is the Holy Ghost headquarters? Y'all, to put it candidly, that's really dumb. Yeah. The Holy Ghost has no local headquarters. He's free in his movement. No one place is where the Holy Ghost sets up his headquarters. He is alive in one place as much as he is in another place. And until we understand that God is working in the life of all of us, irrespective to demographics and geographical location, until we understand that, we won't come together and work together, because a divided church can't unite a fragmented world. I said, wake up. You're with a spouse that's abusive. Stop making excuses for them. Wake up. Believing that if you stay with them long enough, they'll change. No. Wake yourself up. Your life is a wreck, a mess, but you're going to keep doing what you've been doing until God brings a change. Wake yourself up. You're drunk. You're in a stupor. You don't realize that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. Insanity is doing the same thing the same way, expecting a different result. Wake up. Think. Look and see what is, and accept what is as it is until you can change what is into what it ought to be. So the Bible is telling us that we've got to wake ourselves up from the realities that face us. Racism never died. Racism never went to sleep. Even when we didn't see police killing black men and women who are unarmed, it was still happening. We just didn't see it. It's as bad today as it was before. We're just seeing more of it. Emmett Till was not just an aberration. It went to the extreme with him. But Emmett Till was not an aberration. There were many others who were killed behind dirt roads and left for dead, and they got no consequences for their heinous acts. It was happening then. It's happening now. We're just seeing more of it. So don't walk around living in fear as if the devil has awakened. face reality as is. The wrath of God isn't covered on the news. Because the news don't understand what his wrath is. God's wrath is always spiritual. God's wrath is not exercised by giving you a disease. God doesn't show his wrath by giving you high blood pressure or arthritis. That's not God's wrath. God's wrath is when the people of God have no word from God. The nation is in trouble because the church ain't saying nothing. The nation is in trouble because the church is listening to the world more than the world is listening to us. The world is in trouble because we want to get our information from CNN, MSNBC, and some even Fox News, and then think we are educated because we watch the news, but we ain't read the Bible. The wrath of God is exercised on the peace of, on the people of God, because we're walking around without the peace of God. We are saying we are God's people, but we have no peace in our hearts. We're saying we're God's people, but we are as depressed and despondent as those who don't know God. The wrath of God is the fellowship has been fractured from the Father. I don't care what goes on. We ought to be saying, the joy of the Lord is my strength. No matter what goes on, we should be walking around saying, thou will keep us in perfect